Rod Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Kim Weisskopf's thumbnail sketch of the light-fingered filcher. Once a thief. Starring Greg Morris. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company. Also by Beechnut Chewing Tobacco, Shenley Industries, Matus Wine, and International Harvester. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
It's nice to be the best in anything. The title of best pickpocket in the city belongs to Fingers Duncan. He's known throughout the circuit as a natural. But lately, Fingers has been slipping, losing his grip, as it were. And in his search to uncover the source of his inexplicable slump, he will most surely find he has his hands full. Today's story is entitled, Once a Thief. We open at police headquarters. A matronly woman and a plainclothes police officer are peering through the one-way glass at a lamp.
Well, Mrs. Wilkinson, do you recognize any of these men?
I'm afraid not.
You'll be absolutely sure this is the end of the parade.
I'm sure.
All right.
You bums can go. Oh, what'd you bring us in here for in the first place?
Here. Well, I've done all I can, Mrs. Wilkinson. You've seen every petty thief, every pickpocket in the city. Either your bonds were stolen by someone from out of town or a local amateur.
But, officer, why? Why would somebody steal those bonds when all that cash was right there?
You said yourself it was a fundraising affair. Maybe the thief had a soft heart. My guess is he had a soft head. He'll have a lot of trouble trying to pass those bonds. When he does try, we'll let you know.
Thank you. You've been most kind. Oops.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Hold on, Mrs. Wilkinson.
Hi, Blake.
Hello, Fingers. Mrs. Wilkinson, you better check to see that your purse is undisturbed. This man you just bumped into is Fingers Duncan. He was in the lineup.
This nice young man is a pickpocket?
You're just about the best there ever was.
Correction, I used to be.
Everything seems to be in order.
You wear a watch? Any jewelry?
Nothing missing.
All right, Mrs. Wilkinson, we'll be in touch. What is it, Fingers? I'm not really in the mood to chew the fat.
Blake, I'm depressed.
Yeah, what are you telling me for? They got doctors for that.
Blake, I'm washed up, finished. I'm here to tell you not to pick me up anymore.
Don't tell me you're going straight. After all these years, Fingers, I enjoy rousting you.
Yeah, I like you too, Blake. But like I said, it's all over.
Sounds serious.
That's bad, all right. You see, I had this uncle.
Blake. Yeah, Captain. Gotcha. Be right there.
You see, I had this uncle.
You tell it to a shrink, Fingers. Captain's going to bite my head off.
Blake.
Hands against the door. Yeah, you're clean.
I've been trying to tell you.
Yeah, tell me in a few days. I'm sure we'll pick you up again by then. Bye.
Blake!
Yes?
Are you Madame Eliza?
Mistress of the occult, oracle of what lies beyond, card reader, astrologer, palmist, and handwriting analyzer. At your service.
Are you some kind of gypsy? I mean, the way you're dressed.
Well, when need be, yes. What can I do for you?
Well, Madam Eliza, I got a problem.
Oh, come. Be seated. My fee is $10 in advance.
You're not a doctor, are you?
That depends.
If you are, I'm leaving.
In that case, I'm not.
See, I don't trust doctors, especially head doctors. Well, my name is Fingers. Fingers Duncan. I'm a pickpocket. Oh, I was.
Oh, I already know that. I see it in your hand.
You do? Well, I've been a pickpocket all my whole life. Since I was 9, anyways. And I had this uncle, you see, or I did until last month. Uncle Rufus.
And Uncle Rufus died last month.
Yeah. He left me $10,000 in his will.
And your problem is you can't get it.
No, that ain't it. I got it.
And you still got trouble?
Can you help me?
Yes, I believe I can. But first, I must consult the stars.
How long will that take?
Come back tomorrow. I should have an answer by noon.
Okay. I can't tell you how much this means to me.
I have some idea.
See you tomorrow, Madam Eliza.
Farewell.
Hey, who was that grinning idiot that just left? Whatever you told him must have been good.
Gil, you didn't off those bonds today, did you?
No, these things are poison. I must have been out of my mind to lift them from that old broad. Not a soul in town will touch them.
Ah, but I got someone who might.
Yeah, who?
One rich, miserable, grinning idiot.
Thank you for coming down again, Mrs. Wilkinson.
Did you find my bonds, officer?
Not yet, but with your help, we might very soon. This charity bazaar of yours was open to the public, you said.
Yes, that's right. It cost $5 to get in, and then all of the games.
Games, right. That's what I want to know. What kind of games? Who ran them?
Oh, goodness, I don't know. We had booths over much of the property. There were games of chance, mostly.
Who hired these people?
A booking agent, Mr. Fishman. He was recommended by...
Saul Fishman?
Well, yes.
Uh-huh. Thank you, Mrs. Wilkinson. You've been most helpful.
Fingers, the heavens smile upon you.
What did the star say, Madam Eliza? Oh, $10 again?
Naturally.
This is getting to be expensive.
There was a meteor shower last night. It came to me then.
What came to you?
The image of your Uncle Rufus. His face appeared in the night sky.
Oh, really?
He was a wealthy man, your uncle, and you, Fingers, were his favorite nephew.
I was?
And even though he disapproved of your larcenous lifestyle, he decided to leave you 10 G's for one purpose and one purpose alone. He felt that if you had money, his money, money earned legitimately in the business world, you would see the light and mend your ways.
Yeah?
Your Uncle Rufus had it all figured out, except for one thing. What he didn't know was that you are an artist and you love your work.
That's right, I do. I did.
You will work again, Fingers, and soon.
Huh?
By ridding yourself of your uncle's money, by spending it on something hot. Stolen merchandise. Once you do that, you won't have any money. So you'll have to go back to work.
Madam Eliza, I think you got it.
Lucky for you, I happen to have just the thing. Stolen bonds. They're worth 20,000 clams. I'm holding them for a friend who's an artist like yourself. He'll let them go for half the value.
10,000. That's exactly what I got.
Oh, what a coincidence.
How soon can I have the bonds?
Just as soon as you give me the money.
How about this afternoon?
Oh, splendid. I'll be waiting for you.
Madam Eliza, I only got one question.
Yes?
Are you sure this will work? I mean, what if after we make the deal, I still can't get back into the swing of things?
My friend, if by chance you do doubt your ability to steal, and I'm sure you won't, keep these words on the tip of your tongue and say them aloud to remind yourself. I will be a thief. I will be a thief. I will be a thief. Say them.
I will be a thief. I will be a thief. I will be a thief.
This list has all the people who worked Mrs. Wilkinson's fundraiser?
Certainly. Why the hassle?
Somebody stole some bonds from the house. Mrs. Wilkinson would like them back.
Bonds?
$20,000 worth.
Oh, now, wait a minute. I got scruples.
Oh, I hadn't noticed. Fishman, you're an operator. Scratch my back and I'll let you keep operating. If not...
Look, Blake, all but a couple of new acts I can vouch for.
Which couple?
The last two on the list. Guess the number of beans in the jar and the fortune teller.
Madam Eliza?
Yeah, the beans people. They're the lunatics.
What makes you say that?
Numbers. It's one family, 12 of them.
So?
So when I told him this was going to be a charity gig, the old man says the percentage ain't enough. But...
But what?
He showed up anyway, the whole lot of them. Said he'd make his money somehow.
I told you these bonds were poison. Now we're really up a creek.
Well, who figured Fishman to be as crooked as he is?
So now we know. Big deal. Giving him half of what we make is too much. I say we skip town now.
Oh, no. Nothing doing. Fingers will be here any minute with a 10 grand. We get the money, then we skip.
That's too risky.
Look, Gil, it'll take me 5 minutes to close the deal. I'll get the bonds.
Hey, how long do you think we'll be before this chump gets hip to the fact that we're ripping them off?
Gil, this ain't a ripoff. These bonds are worth $20,000. If he's a smart operator, that's what he'll get for them. I swear I put them in this drawer. Hey, what is this? A note?
What's it say?
Dear Madam Eliza, I came back with the money, but you were out. While I was waiting, I started to feel that doubt we were talking about. So I did like you said and started saying over and over, I will be a thief, I will be a thief, I will be a thief. It worked so good, I went right to the drawer and stole your bonds.
Hello? Madam Eliza? I will be a thief. I will be... Stole your bonds. Sincerely. Yeah, this is Blake. I want arrest warrants issued for a Gilbert Hayes and a Madam Eliza Tabachnik. Descriptions there on my desk. Oh, and pickup fingers, Duncan, again. Right, I want to talk to him. There's a what? When did it start? Got it. Get on those other two right away.
What makes you think the creep will be here at the parade?
Every dip in town is here. Parades are like conventions for him. Fingers is here, I tell you.
Yeah, but where? We'll never find him in this mob.
You mean this? Yeah, there he is.
Well, let's get him.
Not yet.
What do you mean, not yet? He'll get away.
He ain't going anywhere. Can't you see he's making a pinch?
Hey, that was smooth. The dude's got his act together.
And don't forget, he's got our bonds. Look, he's sneaking off into the alley, probably to rifle that wall. Now's the chance.
Oh, fingers, the heavens frown on you today.
Madam Eliza, what a pleasant surprise. Sorry I had to leave when I did.
Is this guy for real?
Oh, Gil, I will handle this.
Look at all these greenbacks, Madam Eliza. I have you to thank for getting me over my mental block.
Oh, I'm so glad I could help you, Fingers. But aren't you forgetting something? You stole my bonds. Actually, they belong to Mr. Hayes here.
That's right, Twerp. And I'd like them back, now.
I'd give them to you for good.
Well, what's stopping you?
I don't have them.
Well, where are they?
I sold them.
You passed them? Already? How?
He's lying. I tried all over town.
I am many things, Mr. Hayes, but I'm not a liar. I sold those bonds to a friend of mine, a fence, a highly respected man in his trade. He paid me full value.
What? Who is he?
It doesn't matter, but we will take the money.
I'm afraid I don't have that either.
You're a liar.
Mr. Hayes.
Gentlemen, gentlemen.
Hey, let me take it out of his hide.
No. Fingers, what did you do with the money?
Well, I did like you said, do, Madam Eliza. I got rid of it. I had to. Otherwise, I couldn't work.
I'll give you a job. How'd you like to be a corpse?
What did you do with the $20,000?
I gave it away.
You what?
I gave it away.
Gil, if you don't, I will.
All right, you turkey. Smile pretty.
Oh. That's enough, Hayes.
Hey, what? Who are you? How do you know my name?
My name's Blake. I'm a cop. You're under arrest. Going somewhere, Madam Eliza?
Oh, officer, you must be confusing me with someone else. I'm here for the parade.
In an alley.
Well, I...
You're both under arrest for bond theft.
Blake!
Claiborne, I'm in here. Take these two to headquarters. I'll be there as soon as I can rouse Fingers. Fingers.
Please, don't hurt my hands. Blake, where'd you come from?
Shame on you, Fingers. This isn't your wallet.
That.
It lets you and I return it to its owner, then take a ride downtown. What do you say?
Great. I can't wait.
Do you recall these two working at the bazaar, Mrs. Wilkinson?
Why, yes. This woman was the fortune teller, and he...
Oh, what
Yes, now I remember. He was inside the house much of the time. I thought he was a guest.
You're dreaming, lady.
You can't do this to me. I demand to see my lawyer. Blake, why have I been arrested?
You gave me a bum steer, Fishman. I think you did it on purpose.
Oh, but I see you got the culprits.
Yeah, and they told me what you told them about taking half.
Hey, that's right, Fishman, you crumb.
It was written in the stars.
Oh, shut up. Claiborne, lock him up.
I want to call my lawyer. I have rights.
Let him call the lawyer, then jail him. Well, that's that, Mrs. Wilkinson. Sorry we couldn't get your bonds back, but we got the next best thing. Fingers? I'll let Fingers tell you about it.
I'm awful sorry, ma'am, about selling those bonds, but I got $20,000 for them.
Tell her what you did with the money.
Well, I gave it away to charity. That and the $10,000 my Uncle Rufus left me in his will.
Oh, that's marvelous.
Yeah, and now I'm broke again. I'm back on the circuit. Well, nice meeting you again, ma'am. Guess I'll be leaving.
Fingers?
Yeah?
Mrs. Wilkinson, your necklace.
Where did you... I just had it on.
Get out of here, Fingers. Do that again and I'll throw you in the can.
You know something, Blake?
What?
It's good to be back home.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Once a Thief is an original radio drama adapted by Kim Weisskopf. Greg Morris was heard as Fingers Duncan. Featured in the cast were Michael Rye, June Foray, Scott Ellsworth, Harry Lansing, and Peter Leeds. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Polis, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.